Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we're going to show how to paint the orange skin and scales of Karazai the Scarred. Now, before we begin painting, you'll notice we've already painted the cream underside and that patterning on Karazai. So check that video out if you want to know how to do that. But the first thing we're going to do here is start layering up in preparation for that orange skin tone. So we're going to be using Ungor flesh first. This is going to help bridge that gap between the cream and the orange. Then we're going to move to Bestigor flesh. So the first thing I'm going to do is jump straight onto that Ungor flesh. So what I'm going to do here is just get some of that onto the palette, like so. And I'm going to thin this down a little bit more than I normally would for like a base paint or a layer paint. So I'm just going to add a little bit more, so a couple of paint brushes of water there. And all we're going to do is, so on the actual main body, again, check the box out if you're not sure. So the middle bit here is going to be the, obviously, cream underside. So I'm just going to start applying this Ungor flesh to the side, like so. Obviously, I'll be applying it to the arms. Now, because it's quite runny, it's going in those cracks, nice and easy, like so. Now, to help bridge that gap, I'm just going to quickly switch to my dry brush. I'm just going to gently just rub those into the cream a little bit. This will give you a nice natural blend. Again, just take your time over that and work your way all across the model. Now I'm going to base coat most of the areas I'm going to want in orange with Ungor flesh. And after that, we're going to move on to Bestigor flesh. There we are, that Ungor flesh now applied. You can see you've got a nice little blend between the cream areas and obviously the orange areas we're going to start working on. Now we're going to move on to Bestigor flesh. We're just going to move this a bit further into those scales and sections, so like raised areas on the muscles. We're going to do exactly the same thing, where it's slightly more thinned down, like we did with the Ungor flesh. I'm just going to move that a bit further like that. And then I'm going to get a dry brush and then just blend that in a little bit to the sections where the Ungor flesh is. Again, give it a natural blend and a little bit more contrast there as well. Now that I've applied Bestigor flesh, you can see it's given it a nice blend there, moving in from the actual Wraithbone cream that we started off in the last video, up to the Ungor flesh and now to the Bestigor flesh. So what we're now going to do is start to shade some of those scales and details. I'm going to use Griffhound Orange here, but we're going to heavily thin it down with Contrast Medium. So I'm looking at 5 parts Contrast Medium to 1 part Griffhound Orange. So I'm going to grab myself a medium shade brush, and all I'm going to do is get 5 paintbrushes worth of Contrast Medium on there. That's 4 and that's 5. Give it a quick wash. I'm going to get 1 paintbrush's worth of Griffhound Orange. Just mix that together, like so. This is going to add a nice orangey punch to those recesses as well. If you find it looks a bit too neat, you can always thin it down a little bit more if you wish to. So what I'm going to do, I'm not going to run too much onto the actual Ungor flesh sections. It's more going to be where the Bestigor flesh is. So I'm going to start running that over, like so. If it dries, it will obviously keep it into the recesses. You'll get some stain on the top of those areas, but we're going to dry brush over those in a moment or two when this is all dry. So just work on working it into those recesses and take your time. Now that we've applied the Griffhound Orange and Contrast Medium mix, you can see once it's dry, it's left some little blotchy bits here and there. You've got to be very mindful as well when you're applying this, because it does pool at the bottom, so just make sure you soak that up. So what we're now going to do to help tidy this up is we're going to move on to some dry brush. I'm going to use those layer paints that we started off with, so Bestigor flesh and Ungor flesh. We're just going to softly dry brush those back up. So we'll start with Bestigor flesh first. So all I'm going to do is just load my brush up, and then with any dry brushing, I like to do circular motions, crisscross motions like that. This helps remove a lot of that pigment that's embedded deep in those bristles. Now the idea of this is just to softly pick out some of those scales on the raised areas, and also it'll help remove some of that blotching, like I said. So once I'm happy with that, all I'm going to do is then just start on the shoulder, just gently flip back and forth. As you can see, it's just bringing a little bit more lightness to that orangey tone of the skin. That first dry brush done of Bestigor flesh, now that was quite a subtle coat, because what we're actually doing there is just to get rid of some of that blotching. So what we're now going to move on to is Ungor flesh. And we're just going to softly start dry brushing over those scales as well. And then here, you'll start to see a bit more of a difference. If you wanted to, for a little bit more contrast, you can always go a little bit lighter and get like a bone colour as well, to add a little bit more punch to those scales. But I'm just going to leave it at this. There we are, with that dry brush done, the orange skin and scales of Karazai the Scarred is now completed. Now, by following the methods and techniques in this guide, you can easily apply this to any monsters, beasts or dragons in your collection. Now, we're not going to stop here. We're also going to do another video on Karazai, and that's going to be doing the red scales and also things like the red wings as well. So adding a little bit more punch to that orange. So check out for that video as well. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this one. Hope you enjoy painting your own dragons, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.